think there's a lot of confusion amongst us in the clinical world about what's the difference between inadequate response and TRD. And also, from a regulatory point of view, there are some differences. So from a regulatory point of view and in a research setting, TRD is actually strictly defined as a less than 25% improvement to two or more antidepressants. Now, many of us don't use scales, so we can't come up with that.
Right.
And I think in the real world, a lot of us feel like inadequate response. But inadequate response, which is what most of our atypical antipsychotics are FDA approved for, is actually less than 50% response to only one or more antidepressants in the current episode. So there's a little bit of overlap there. But how about this, Rob?
Yeah, and this is a nice point, Andy. And one of the observations we've all made is the patient in front of you, their symptom score indicates they are in remission. Their PHQ may be less than 5 as an example. And then the patient will say, I don't feel myself. I don't feel well. And one of the criticisms of most of the definitions of treatment-resistant depression has been that the definitions have been clinician-centric, symptom-centric.
That's true.
And it doesn't take into consideration quality of life or functional recovery.
Yeah.
And there's been a call to maybe change the moniker.
Yep.
Maybe rather than calling it treatment-resistant depression, which some people find almost a bit kind of stigmatizing.
Absolutely.
To call it difficult to treat depression.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's
really
more
like
conversational.
Yeah.
The focus is less on symptoms. It's more on the overall holistic recovery of the patient.
Well, I like that too, because when you say treatment resistant, that implies that there's nothing I can do. They'll never get better. Actually, I do want to make one point on this one here, if you don't mind. But real quickly here, there's something new on this slide, Roger, we should point out. At the top of the slide, you know, we're sort of taught to wait 4, 6, maybe 8 weeks to see if an antidepressant's working. Newer research says that it should actually be after 2 weeks now. And if a patient is not at least 25% improved after 2 weeks, then you should do something. Now, what that something is could be raise the dose, add, switch. That's up to you. But we shouldn't be waiting around for this to happen. So hopefully that's helpful to you in thinking about.